This cow's front left foot is incredibly sore, and when we uncover this hole, we understand why. Plus, Kevin smells a little off.
Come with me, this cow has got a really sore front left foot. I spotted her on the way in actually, and now her foot's in the air. You can see just how high her heels are. These gloves are a nightmare to get on. Look at this, these heels are extremely high because she's avoiding walking on it. So that tells me straight away the problem isn't here, it's up here where the heels are.
Right, because both heels are a little bit high, we're actually going to correct this angle by tipping it back.
Usually we don't take much off the heels because we try to spare the heel height, because that's what you want to do usually. Cow wears her heels a little bit too much, you want to kind of tip them back up onto her toes. This is literally the opposite though.
Hey darling, you know what? And get in that car. Leave a little note and we'll drive real far.
Between 48 and 50 degrees is what the angle of the hoof should be, and that is about right now. Like that kind of angle.
Oh, a big slither to begin with. Just gonna model these feet out like we normally do, routinely. The problem is gonna be up in here though. You can hear her protesting a little bit in the background, I'm sure. Not sure what it is she's saying, but she's probably not very happy that she's in this crush. See, the problem is going to be in here, the white line junction where the wall horn actually connects to the sole of the cow's foot. And if we slice through here, this is where the problem is. You kind of work around the edges of a lesion like this. Find out how far it extends and then work your way slightly more deeply all the time. I think we'll get some water to clean that out.
Not sure if you can tell, but that hole there goes right up into the interior of her foot.
Really, really deep.
I think what we're going to do actually is we're going to reduce this part of the hoof with the grinder because it's so hard.
Let's get out, we can leave this city. Let's drive to the open air. Yeah, the countryside is so pretty with the wind blowing in your hair.
Now that we've started to do that, actually it's started to reveal a few more things. There's a problem here coming all the way through, but also you can see the hoof horn separating here. I think actually we'll take the knife here and swipe that away. This is a problem that's been going on for quite some time because it's descended. Stay still, because it's descended right down the outside of her foot. Look at that, there's gonna be another layer in there as well, look. Yep. And again, look at all that muck that is tracked from here. Every step is pushing it further and further up into her foot. We'll just jet this out, you'll see. She is really protesting at being in here. This isn't hurting her. I know it's not because there's no live tissue that I'm pulling through or anything like that, so her protests are probably just because she's in the crush actually.
That's her tail swishing around, you can hear in the background. I need to get all of this out. Open it up completely so that we can treat it topically. Can actually see right through the foot here because of that hole, so I know that when I slice through here there's no danger whatsoever of hitting something I don't want to. All of these kind of leaves of hoof horn, if you like, are where the hoof is actually attached to the interior of the cow's foot via lamina, where the word laminate comes from. Oh, there's another layer to it there, look. I think actually around this side we've done just about as much as we can do. Well, maybe open it up a wee bit more. Oh, that's better actually. I'm glad I persevered just for that little bit longer. That's better actually. She's really not a happy chappy at all, is she? Mind you, calling her chappy I suppose probably doesn't help matters. Would you look at that? Just spotted all of this is actually detached as well. Look at that. It actually goes right through to her heel. Oh, and this. Just snip right through that. I'm switching blades constantly because it's difficult to get into this part of her foot. Oh, it's starting to look better. It's coming to an end. All of these delaminated layers of hoof horn are finally beginning to merge into one. I'm just gonna grab the grinder here and prepare this outside claw ready for the block. But also, while I've got it in my hand, I'm reducing the inside claw just a little bit more. It's slightly bulky and she's not gonna need it with that block in place, is she? Right, Maestro, have you got a block?
On it.
What aftershave are you wearing?
None. Did you get any Christmas
presents? Did you not?
I, you did.
Actually, right, with Kevin's aftershave issues out of the way, by the way, feel free to send him some aftershave to the Hoof GP at Wigtown, Scotland. It will get here. Hoof GP, Wigtown, Scotland. Right, let's take a look at this foot.
On it.
I was just about to ask him to get a wrap, and he's like, on it, I'm on it.
Ever ready.
So Kevin knew I was going to ask for a wrap, so he had it ready already. When the cow's hoof is open like that, we need to try and dry up the corium so that some good hoof horn can grow in its place, protected by the dried out corium. Kind of like a scab when you get a cut on your finger. The scab is there to protect the healing process. Right, with that block completely healed and her all bandaged up, time to get her out. As we can all tell, she's not very keen to stay in the cuss for much longer. That's why we're constantly trying to work as a team to get through these cows as quickly as we can, because they hate being separated from the rest of the herd. They're herding animals and that instinct is really strong.
Right, let's get her out and see how she's walking. shaky.
So we can all see that she's a bit shaky to begin with. The collecting yard that she's walking through right now is on a slight slope, and it's polished concrete, so it's very, very slippery. When a cow doesn't even have a block on, traction on surfaces like this isn't fantastic, so she's nervous anyway. And now she's got a block to contend with. But as soon as she gets outside, look at her. She's starting to walk much more confidently. The block is coming into its own, and she's starting to realise that it's not as sore as it was a few moments ago. Maybe all that fuss she was causing in the crush wasn't worth it. This was the Hoof GP, and you were the herd. Thank you very much for watching. And as always, if you've made it this far, then it stands to reason you've kind of, sort of, enjoyed the video in some sort of way. So please consider joining this amazing community that we call the herd by subscribing to this channel.